Hi, welcome to another episode of the On.NET Show. Today we've got Jasmine Greenaway with us, and we're going to learn a bit about how GitHub and Visual Studio work together. Yeah. So tell us a little bit about yourself, and then we'll jump into the topic.
Absolutely. So my name is Jasmine Greenaway, as you said before.
Totally.
I am a cloud developer advocate here at Microsoft. Pretty much what I do is I get to talk about all the fun things that devs can do with the cloud, and I get to show them how to do that with words and code. So I'm either writing or speaking or writing code to show them how to do that. Previously, I worked at GitHub, and I worked on the GitHub tools, GitHub extension for Visual Studio, and it was a lot of fun, and I'm really excited to show it off a little bit.
Right, so you're totally at home in the space then.
Yeah, yes, awesome. For sure.
Okay, so so a few years ago, that's when GitHub, or how long ago was it that GitHub actually made the GitHub extension for Visual Studio?
It started, I believe, in the end of 2015. So this is before I joined.
Right.
It was effort with a few devs, and they got in this about a 5-person team now. It's gotten larger, and it's a Visual Studio extension that is written with WPF, and it uses the GitHub API to make calls and stuff like that. So yeah.
Definitely, because I think with a lot of people, you know, GitHub is clearly one of the big hosted Git servers that people use in the world. Mm-hmm. So having first class support for GitHub makes a ton of sense.
Yeah, for sure. And it's like completely transparent because it's all open source, so everybody can see what's going on with it.
Right, and I know GitHub has both public and private repositories. I assume this works for both.
Yes.
Yeah, makes sense. So I think there are a lot of people that are using Git with Visual Studio for the first time. You know, they've heard that Git's a thing. They probably used some other source control manager in the past. Maybe they'll install the GitHub extension for VS to kind of get started. Do you think that it pretty much has all the functionality that most people need to get started, or is there anything else that they need to learn?
So it has most of the features to get started. So whether or not you want to pull down or clone a new repo, or create a new repo on your own, or even commit some code, whether it be your code from your repo or somebody else's, you have the option to do that. And you also have the option as a maintainer to kind of go through all of the open pull requests that might be that might need some attention, and kind of review that and make comments on that right in Visual Studio stuff without even having to go to the site.
Right. So one of the things I love about Git and GitHub is it's pretty much centered around collaboration.
Yes.
And so we use Git and GitHub a ton on our team, and we try and be as collaborative with it as possible. So maybe what you can show us is, if you're as collaborative as you and I are, some of the features in GitHub, in the GitHub extension, that kind of enable that. Like you were showing me before, how comments show up in line. I thought that was super compelling.
Yeah, sure. So I'll show that off real quick. So what I've done here in in Visual Studio is, here's the extension, and I went ahead and I created a new repo, and you can see it down in the bottom corner here called My New Repo. And I have a test branch here that I, just for fun. And what I've done here is I have an actual separate GitHub account called My Evil Paladik. So my handle on GitHub is Paladik. It's a long story. Ask me about it later. But I have a test account called Evil Paladik. And what I've done is that I've created a pull request with the evil one. And what I went ahead and did with my real account is made a comment to that to that pull request, right in the file, not like a general comment, just right in the file.
Right.
So if
which
I
is super common on that's kind of how things work.
Yeah.
On GitHub.
Yes, exactly. So what I have here is I'm in the new repo, repo, and I have my pull request here, and you can see like I can actually go to it. I can go to the site if I wanted to, but I'm just gonna click right here. I have the details. I didn't put a description here, and I can actually, view the rest of it on the site if I wanted to. But what I'm going to do is just go ahead and click on this comment button here, this comment link here. And so what Evil Paladik did was add some new text to my readme file, saying just adding some new text. That's all she said. And what I did is I went in here and added a comment. Now I actually did this on the site, but if I wanted to add a new comment here, this is a new comment, and I press comment here, it will, you also see this on the site. So, and Evil, if Evil Paladik had a version of Visual Studio that with Git the extension installed, they would be able to see it as well. So if I go and view this conversation, you will see that my comment is there.
16 seconds ago.
Yeah.
Right, so what I kind of hear is, in the past, to fully participate in a kind of collaborative GitHub process, you had to be on the website.
Yes.
And now we've kind of made it so that Visual Studio users can just pretty much stay in Visual Studio and really kind of have no downside.
Yeah.
They just get the whole collaborative process.
Right. It's great because for me, as somebody who's been using Visual Studio for years, you know, I have everything that I need there. You know, I have my code, but also I have, you know, I can manage my packages. I can manage, you know, any just any like kind of files or anything. Everything I need mostly is in Visual Studio. And with, you know, the addition of, you know, Git integration and also GitHub, it makes it a lot easy for me to be collaborative right in Visual Studio without having to jump around too much.
Makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
Another thing I like about GitHub, and I'm not sure if we can see it here, but syntax highlighting is really great for .NET languages.
Yes.
You can probably see that. So it has, that's kind of like a first class mm-hmm. characteristic, and
basic.
Yeah, so looks like it should.
Mm-hmm.
So I certainly feel super comfortable. Mm-hmm. So the other scenario, you know, we started talking about the new users. So I'm one of those kind of dyed-in-the-wool, use Git from the command line, and I actually use, you know, the default Vim editor for typing all my comments, although most of the time I'll just do that on the command line with the -m. Keyword to type my message. What am I missing in Visual Studio? What would compel me to kind of get out of the cold mm-hmm. For on the command line and kind of come into the warmth in Visual Studio?
Mm-hmm. Well, the Git integration in VS has the very basic capabilities. So there's definitely going to be things that you're going to need in the command line proper, for example. Things like rebasing. You can do merge conflicts in Visual Studio, and that's like definitely an option for you. But if you want to do all the command line, you're able to, and you know Visual Studio is not going to stop you and say like, oh, why'd you do that in the command line? You should have done
totally.
It here. So there's things like that. And
so maybe it's merge conflicts would be the thing that would bring me into Visual Studio, because I will say that handling merge conflicts in Vim mm-hmm. is not super awesome.
Uh-huh.
It's something, you know, it's like, here's the stuff coming from one direction, I can't even remember what it's called, and here's incoming and here's current or whatever it's called.
Target branch.
Yeah,
and, yeah.
It's incoming and head, I think it is.
Yeah.
And then it's like, oh, I can never remember which direction it is.
Yeah.
So maybe VS would help me with that.
Yeah, for sure. Different editors call it different things. So especially if you're coming from Vim to like Visual Studio, yeah, they're probably a little bit of a learning curve in terms of like what they call things there. But Visual Studio can definitely help you out with that. And I'm trying to think if there's any other concepts in terms of on the command line that you'll want to use the command line specifically for. But I can't, none come to mind. But the other great thing with Visual Studio and the Git integration is that there's an option in Visual Studio that allows you to jump straight to command line if you choose to. So if you go into Team Explorer here in Visual Studio, and you actually go to the Connect page here, and you have you have your list of GitHub hosted repositories, and then you have your local repositories
right.
Here. And say I wanted to, you know, check out my new repo in the command line. I just right click here, and I go to Open Command Prompt. And there I am. I'm there, and I can do whatever Git commands I need to.
Git status.
Yeah, Git status, or whatever you'd like.
Yeah. So one thing that people might not know is gitignore is a pretty important concept.
Mm-hmm.
There's actually a gitignore file for Visual Studio.
Yes.
So whenever I start a new repository, I type git in my search engine. .gitignore Visual Studio, and it always takes me to that file, which is actually on GitHub.
Yeah.
And then that helps a lot.
Yeah. And then the neat thing with the extension is it also includes it as well. And not only does it include creating, adding the gitignore file, it does it by default, we'll add it for you by default, but you can also add a license. So, you know, if you decide, oh, I need an MIT license here, it'll grab that for you. It's totally optional, up to you. And then you also have the option of making it a private repository before you even send it off to GitHub.
Nice. Can we just cover what the gitignore file is for, just in case people don't know that?
Sure. So a gitignore file is pretty much a file that Git overlooks the gitignore file. So pretty much anything that is in the gitignore file will not be committed, not be pushed to GitHub, not be pushed to whatever your source control hosting service is.
Yes, because there's a ton of files that are just completely inappropriate to check in, mostly binaries.
I think
that's your number one thing. Mm-hmm. And it just makes your Git life so much easier, and it avoids a ton of mistakes.
Yes, exactly. So it's very, very handy, and it's very helpful to have it just there available for you.
Okay, so we should probably just, where do I install this? What does that look like?
So if you go to the GitHub for Visual Studio repo, you will see, everything that's been going on with it, what everyone is pushing, what kind of code everyone's pushing, what kind of features are next. But there's a link up here right in this description called visualstudio.github.com. It'll take you to the site, and you can download it from there. Or you can go into extensions in Visual Studio under tools, extensions, and updates, and just search for GitHub extension for Visual Studio.
Okay. So for a lot of people, that's probably the easiest path.
Yes, exactly.
And then you just kind of install it, and you're off to the races.
Yeah, and just your typical, install, restart, and it's there. And then all you have to do is just log in and authenticate if you have 2FA on.
Yeah, 2FA.
Yep, do. Yes, do 2FA.
As Microsoft employees, we're actually required to use that.
Yes, we are, yes.
Because security.
Yes. And then you just go ahead and you can clone some repos of your own, create a new repo. Add any existing repositories, any local repositories, you can add it in Visual Studio, and then if it's hosted on GitHub, it'll show up in your list of GitHub repos.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Well, I think I'm going to be giving up my Vim habit pretty soon now. So any closing thoughts?
No, just check out the repo, check out the extension. If you see something that you find interesting or like an interesting feature, go ahead and send a issue or send an issue to send some love if you like it.
And it's free to use.
It's free to use.
Awesome. Yes. Well, thanks for listening and watching another episode of the On.NET Show. And today was with Jasmine Greenaway, and we learned about the GitHub extension for Windows.